In this comparison, I have pulled out a set of type 1 acids in which charge delocalization plays a significant role in cation stability. So for the different protonated forms of various functional groups here, we're going to look at the best charge delocalization resonance structures that we can find to see where that cation can also reside, what atoms that cation will reside on. And we're going to find out that these delocalized forms greatly influence the stability of the charge species, and because of the stability of the charge species, it's going to have great effects on the pKa values. So for the protonated ketone, we'll see that there's relatively little delocalization available, whereas in the case of this protonated guanidine group, we have the ability to spread charge over three nitrogen atoms, and those atoms being nitrogen are going to greatly offer stability to that cation, making it a very weak acid. All right, so let's pull out those delocalized forms. We can draw the resonance contributor. The best resonance contributor we can come up with for the ketone makes a 6-electron carbocation species, not a very good species, and that reflects the poor stability of the protonated ketone. In the case of the ester, we can spread that positive charge over two oxygen atoms, and in the case of the amide, we can spread that positive charge over one nitrogen atom and one oxygen atom. The presence of that nitrogen atom makes the protonated amide more stable than the protonated ester. And as I mentioned, in the case of the protonated guanidine, the guanidinium cation, we have the ability to spread that positive charge not just only over this atom as well as the initial atom, but you'll see that you could draw a resonance structure that also puts the positive charge on that third atom. The ability to spread charge over three atoms, and especially nitrogen, makes the guanidine, protonated form of guanidine, a very stable cation. The fact that that cation is so stable means that the loss of this proton is done with great difficulty. It's very reluctant. The cation is very reluctant to give up that proton because of the stability of that cation, making guanidinium a very weak acid compared to a protonated ketone, where the lack of charge delocalization gives this proton great proton power. It's lost with ease, making it a very strong acid. So these examples show the role of charge delocalization. You'll notice that they introduce different atom types, but we just want to know where that positive charge is, how many different atoms it's on, and what those atoms are. Are they the kinds of atoms that stabilize, for example, in this case, positive charge?